Hi everyone, welcome to JustFeg Network TV, a place where you can get the latest information on things happening around the world, and you are in the right place. Please click the red subscribe button and also press the bell icon next to it so you can be notified for an update on any published news. Header statesman and Afenifere leader Chief Ayo Adebanjo has scolded Kaduna State Governor Nasir El-Rufai for dictating the direction Nigeria should follow in determining the 2023 presidency. The governor had warned within the week said rotation of the presidency should stop and give way for competence. He warned that any attempt to arm-twist the South with the 1999 constitution may lead to the nation's disintegration. You want to dictate the term in which we are going to live together. Who are you to do that? When the white men amalgamated us, did they consult us? Since the amalgamation is causing trouble, then let us de-amalgamate and let everybody go back to his father's house, he warned. In this interview with Vincent Kalu, the leader of Afenifere, the Yoruba sociocultural group said Nigerians should restructure to come up with a people's constitution which should be a guide on how to live together and who should occupy the presidency. We are living in denial. Even when the truth is staring at us in the face, we choose to deny it. You can't solve the problem of this nation in any form until you restructure the country. How can the president have to keep security from Abuja in Oshogbo? That is the crux of the matter, and everything you lay on in heat, it is false. Of late, the Fulani herdsmen kidnap people in the southwest, southeast, south-south, and you deny it. They kill people, you deny. They rape and man people, you deny. And look the other way around. But when they kidnap the pastor of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, they release the victim immediately, but left the kidnappers because you don't want to stigmatize them. Why are you hiding them and continue to deny? Each time you deny, evidences show they were responsible. Last week in Taraba State, soldiers killed the policeman who arrested one of those responsible for kidnapping and set him free. All these problems are interwoven. I say it, the Yoruba, the indigents of this area, don't trust any security outside the people of our country, of our own area. This is how fundamental it is. Then you go over the governors and go to the traditional rulers. What type of regime is that in federal constitution? We are not pretending Buhari doesn't want to do anything because he is Fulani. We have every evidence to show that herdsmen are everywhere. They use sophisticated weapons. They kill people. They burn houses and sack community, but those in authorities claim not to know who are committing these atrocities. When they committed the same atrocities in Benue, the state government went to meet the president and said the Mayeti Ala people were responsible and asked the Inspector General of Police to go there, but the IGP didn't go there, he disobeyed him. As the chief security officers and the commander-in-chief, what did Buhari do to him? Nothing. He even wanted to extend his tenure. You don't waste your time pretending as if you don't know where your problems are coming from. There is no honesty in the whole thing. Talking about security, Buhari and his government are not serious about it. If they are serious about it, they should do something. Let the governors be responsible for security in their state. You call them the chief security officers of their state. But have they got the instrument to control the police? The police are still controlled from above. And we have evidence that police arrest these people and they are asked to release them. We have evidence that Fulani men who killed the daughter of our leader, Pariben Fashoroti, our brother, went to the police station. The police told him that Fulani people were responsible and that they knew them. Then you are the leader. You looked the other way and pretended that nothing happened. The head of the police would say they were setting up an inquiry, which doesn't happen. Under your watch, two security agencies are quarreling and fighting. You say you are setting up inquiry. The Economic and Financial Crime Commission, EFCC, and the National Intelligence Agency, NIA, were fighting, and you said you were setting up inquiry. Till today, nobody has heard about the inquiry and its outcome. This is not a pretending matter. We should sit and talk. We say let's use the 2014 Confab report. You said you didn't set it up, but it has far-fetched recommendations. If you are serious about it, what is wrong there that you don't want? Get along and get it right. You know what to do, but you don't want to do it. You want to tell me that the local people of Benue were in charge of their security the first time you attacked them. It was by surprise. The second time, the same. The third time, the same. Killing thousands. And at each time it happens, you will say you are on top of it. Another time it happens, you are on top of it. Or you say God will punish the killers. Who are you deceiving? You think you are deceiving people who don't know what they are being deceived? Buhari and his government know what to do, and they refuse to do it to the end. The killings and other security problems in the country because they are interested in the commotion. Kaduna State Governor Nasser El-Rufai said that the presidency should go to competent persons and no more by rotation. Do you share the same view with him? He is talking nonsense. Is it to make constitution for us? Let the people sit and say that, is what they want, and not what the governor is babbling. What is he talking about? So if he talks nonsense, you people can't stop him. Does he own the presidency? What we are saying is that this constitution he is relying upon is not our constitution. Let the people sit and make their own constitution. The constitution which they make, you said, you don't accept because we didn't set up the committee. Which one are you setting up? You continue to rule us under a constitution which we say we don't want. You use the provision of the constitution which we have rejected to continue to oppress us. Who is El-Rufai to tell us how we should be governed? How can a section of the country dictate the type of constitution of living together in this country, which is an objectionable thing and which is causing all the problems in the country? You want to have unity where you are the rider and others are the horns. You want to dictate the terms in which we are going to live together. Who are you to do that? When the white men amalgamated us, did they consult us? Since the amalgamation is causing trouble, then let us de-amalgamate and let everybody go back to his father's house. Some people are asking, why is the Kaduna governor asking for the jettison of zoning now? Any idea? I'm a consistent man, and I have questioned his power to direct us on what we should do. We have to go to the root. He is talking about it because that is what the fraudulent constitution say. Let him say it when we have an agreed constitution. When he is saying is what the present constitution says. But we are saying that the present constitution was not made by us, and so it is a fraud. This nonsense he is talking will not save us. What will save us is for us to make a constitution that will pass through referendum and not this thing foisted on us by the military. This argument that sovereignty is with the National Assembly is false. When we talk about the constitution that will pass through referendum, you say referendum is not in the constitution. Which constitution? Is it the one that was imposed on us? Thanks to all my viewers today. So I think Ayo Adebanjo is actually saying the truth. The northerners are the problems of this country. The truth might be bitter, but it must be told. Nigerians have agreed to be governed by the current constitution. And I think Buhari branded IPOB, IMN, as terrorists, which is the Islamic Movement of Nigeria, as terrorists. But the real terrorists, who are his kinsmen, are all over the place. Killing, kidnapping, raping, burning houses. The present government, too, are treated as kings and princes all over the places, and yet he expects Nigerians to remain as one inseparable entity. So thanks to all my viewers today. What is your own take concerning this no zoning, no Nigerian, says by Ayo Adebanjo? Kindly drop your comments below. And if you are subscribed to my channel, thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. If you are yet to subscribe, please press the subscription button. And also press the red bell icon to get updates on any of my videos. Bye.